This is the third video of our Fran Pico project and the final video of our Conering Lights project, in which we use our own Fran Pico controller. This video covers the installation of the hardware. We begin with the full electrical diagram for this project. The relay is located inside the Fran SEM module. Our Pico module is located in the cabin. The CAN bus wires, the signal wires, and the positive power to the Pico are all coming from the Fran SEM. And the power wires in the Fran SEM are connected to different fuses. Both of the fuses are on the circuit 37F. The positive wires from the relay go to the light units. White goes to the left, yellow goes to the right. Purple wires are the ground wires, and all are connected to the body of the car. The hardware installation will begin with the installation of Pico. It is installed in the cabin. I designed and printed small enclosure so that I can easily remove the controller if I need to. All the printed parts for this project are on the project's GitHub page, links to which are in the description under every video of this project. The only problem here is that the design is not very good for debugging, because the NeoPixel LED light is facing the opposite side. The Pico is powered by the USB-C connector with two wires. The ground is attached to the body of the car here, and the 5-volt positive wire, also the two light control wires, white and yellow at pins 1 and 25, and also two CAN bus wires, are all coming from the Fran SEM. The gray wire is not on the diagram and is also going to the Fran SEM. It is the control wire to control the rotation of my GoPro servo based on the steering ankle, as I mentioned in the previous video of this project. So in total we have 5 wires running from Pico to the Fran SEM plus the gray wire. In the Fran SEM, I found a good place for the switching relay. From the fuse 36, I run the wire to the 12-to-5-volt converter, from which I run the wire to feed this 5-volt relay, and also to provide the power to the Pico controller in the cabin. From the fuse 33, I run the wire to the common connectors of the both relays. Then, from the normally open connectors of each relay, I run the wires to the corresponding light unit via 20 amp fuses. Now installing the light units themselves. First, locate the car on the leveled ground and draw the horizontal line on the black mesh. Transfer this line to the gray covers and remove the black mesh. Drill 100 mm holes for both lights. The gray covers have to be flat on the rear side, like they are on the front side. Be careful here and try not to damage the vehicle's outside temperature sensor. It is attached on this side to the same gray cover. Additional hardware that I am using in this project are the two brackets, front and rear, for each light unit. They are needed to reinforce the gray covers. Because the covers are too thin and too weak to hold the light units. The STL files are also on this project's GitHub page. If you don't have a printer, you can use sites like PCBWays to upload the STL files and order the printing. These brackets must be strong. So I printed them solid inside, I mean with 100% fill. Because the vehicle's gray covers are not flat, but are bent, I had to design and print the rear bracket with the same bending radius. But the front blue bracket I printed flat. This is due to the printing process limitations. And later, I put it into the near boiling water for about half an hour and bent it to the same radius as the gray covers. The PLA filament is very good for this job. As guidance, I used the black mesh. It has the same bent radius as the gray covers. After the gray covers are flat in the back, I dismantled the light unit, then fixed the rear light holder with both blue brackets together, first with two bolts. The idea behind this is that the blue brackets tighten the gray cover from both sides, and this creates a single strong holder for our light unit. The last 10 months have proven that this works very well. After the rear light holder and the brackets are fixed, I screwed back the front of the light unit to the rear light unit holder. On the right-hand drive cars, this side is very hard to work on, because behind the gray plastic cover we have the windscreen washer, and our access there is only about 3 centimeters. And so you need a very short screwdriver. This is how the brackets with the light unit look at the rear. We then have to solder the wires to prepare the connectors to the light bulbs. Because I use LED bulbs, I run their wires through the ferrite cores to try to reduce the interference from the LED bulbs. And I would strongly advise to have this. Now we can test our project. It works well, and the currently set 4-second delay before switching off also works. To fine adjust the vertical angle of the light units, I make sure that the car is leveled. Then, with slight rotation of the unit, I adjust its vertical line. After that, I trim the black mesh by beginning from the center and bit by bit trimming the mesh until it will tightly fit around the light. After the meshes are cut to correct shape, I paint the front blue brackets gray to blend them with the gray covers. I simply mask the light units and the surrounding areas with the silicone grease. And I remove grease after the paint is dry. I had to do this because at the time of printing I did not have any gray filament. I also designed and printed the bezels. To harmonize with the colors of the car, we have choice of three colors, basically. We can do them in black or gray, but they can also be printed or painted or wrapped in chrome. I ended up with having them black to blend with the mesh and look smaller. So this is all the Contouring Lights project. And as you see, it is fairly easy to implement.